When we think about forests, we usually think about the tall trees and sometimes the understory, but a really critical part of the architecture of a forest are the fallen trees and the timber on the ground. In these forests, fallen trees store an enormous amount of carbon. We've done measurements using line transects across our long-term sites and discovered that on average, these forests support about 350 tonnes of fallen timber per hectare, an extraordinary number. That's more than the entire biomass of most of the world's forests, and that's just in the fallen timber alone. Often after these logs have been on the forest floor for a number of years, they're colonised by mats of moss and lichens, and they're really important. They form a shell around the outside of the tree, and that means that these fallen areas of fallen timber store very large amounts of water, which then bleeds slowly back into the system and contributes to the stream flow as part of the water cycle in these forests. They're also important runways for quite a wide range of animals, and many of them develop hollows and become nesting sites for rodents like bush rats and native marsupials like the dusky antechinus. So the fallen timber is a really critical resource that plays key roles in habitat, nutrient cycling, substrates for other plants to be able to develop. And it's really a poorly understood but very important part of the dynamics of these really special systems.